Why did Jesus command Peter to feed his sheep? So in John chapter 21, in verse 16, we read, He saith to him, the second time, Simon, son of Jonath, lovest thou me? He saith to him, Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He saith unto him, Feed my sheep. So God has given us command to go forth, find a sheep, and feed them. Now, the problem is, there are preachers and pastors in the world today who are not feeding God's sheep, but they are feeding themselves. As we read in Ezekiel chapter 34, beginning in verse 2. Son of man, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel. Prophesy and say unto them, Thus saith the Lord unto the shepherd, Woe to the shepherds of Israel that feed themselves. Should not the shepherds feed the flocks? So what we're going to see here is that these shepherds were false prophets who were starving the flock by not preaching the true gospel. And as a result, the sheep were not healed, as we read in verse 4. The diseased ye have not strengthened, neither have ye healed that which was sick, neither have you bound up that which was broken, neither have you brought again that which was driven away, neither have ye sought that which was lost. And so what we're finding here is when we don't feed the sheep with the true gospel, they cannot be healed of their sin, and they remain lost. So let's examine some verses that also deal with being lost to see how that relates to our spiritual condition. For example, in Luke chapter 15, verse 6, we read about the prodigal son who was lost. And when he cometh home, he calleth together his friends and neighbors, saying unto them, Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost. Then skipping down to verse 24, For this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. They began to be merry. So God is telling us here that when we're lost, we're like a prodigal son who wasn't saved. So he is like a lost sheep that we read about in Ezekiel chapter 34, who was not healed, and he wasn't healed because he was not fed with the true gospel. We also find other places where the word lost is translated as destroy, as in Luke chapter 6, verse 9. And we also find that it is translated as the word perish in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 18, where we read, For the preaching of the cross to them that perish, foolishness, but unto us which are saved is the power of God. And so it is through the preaching of the gospel of the cross of Christ by which we are saved. And if we don't receive that gospel, we are lost, we perish, we are destroyed. And so that is the spiritual condition of God's elect before they become saved. They are like lost sheep. And so, as we preach the gospel, these lost sheep will hear God's voice. And through that hearing, they will become saved.